Hello everyone, in this session we'll be learning about the x-rays of the lower limb. So let's start with this x-ray. What is the name of this x-ray? This is an x-ray of pelvis with both the hip joint. Okay, many a time students just say that this is an x-ray of hip joint, but that is not correct because the entire pelvis is visible with both the hip joint. Okay, so the correct name would be, it is a plane skyagram anteroposterior view of pelvis with both the hip joint. Okay, so now we'll describe one by one. Pelvis is formed by the two hip bones, the sacrum. Okay, so identify the parts of the hip bone. This part is ilium, this part is ischium, this part is pubis. The two pubis are joined together here by this pubic symphysis. Okay, which type of joint is this? This is a secondary cartilaginous joint. And here we can see the ilium articulating with the sacrum. Which joint is this? This is a plane variety of synovial joint. Okay, so the midline bone here is sacrum. Then here we can see one opening here. That opening is the obturator foramen. Okay, so that is seen here, and above it there is the superior ramus of the pubis, the inferior ramus. The inferior part is also referred to as the ischiopubic ramus. Okay, and ischium has got a projection called as the ischial tuberosity. Okay, and look at the parts of the femur. The upper end of the femur are visible. This is the head of the femur, this is the neck of the femur, this is the greater trochanter, this is the lesser trochanter. Okay, this is the upper part of the shaft. And there is one important feature to be looked here in this x-ray, that is something called as Shenton's line. What is Shenton's line? We know this obturator foramen. Look at this upper margin of the obturator foramen. When we trace it, it becomes continuous here with the lower part of the neck of the femur. Okay, so this is a continuous line that we can trace here. This line is referred to as Shenton's line. It has got clinical significance. If this line is not like a smooth curve, that means it indicates fracture of neck of the femur, or else it could be dislocation of the head of the femur. Okay, so this Shenton's line is very frequently asked question in this skyagram. Okay, so this was about the x-ray of pelvis with both the hip. Okay, let's see the next skyagram now. Yes, let's try to identify this skyagram. So this is basically an x-ray of the knee region. Okay, I'm telling knee region because it has got knee joint as well as some additional parts adjacent to the knee. Okay, here also many a time students say this is x-ray of just knee joint. Okay, because knee joint is just a small part in the entire skyagram. The correct term should be knee region. Okay, and it is showing two different views. This view is anteroposterior view and this view is lateral view. Okay, let's try to identify the bones here. This is the lower end of the femur, this is the upper end of the tibia, this one is the upper end of fibula. Okay, the space here, that is with joint space, this is the knee joint space which is seen. And in the lateral view, identify this bone. This is the patella. Okay, this patella is not seen clearly here because in an anteroposterior view the patella gets overlapped with the lower end of the femur. That's why it is not seen clearly here. So in the lateral view it is seen clearly. Okay, so two different views are taken to check for the fractures. Like if there is side to side displacement of the fracture, it would be visible in this AP view. Okay, if there is an anteroposterior displacement in the fracture, it would be visible in this lateral view. Okay, then look at the upper end of tibia and fibula. Okay, so basically you have to name the x-ray correctly and identify the normal anatomical parts that are seen in the skyagram. Okay, and additional viva questions may be patella is which type of bone, it is a sesamoid bone. Knee joint is which type of joint, it is a modified hinge variety of synovial joint. Then this superior tibiofibular joint, it is which type of joint, it is a plane variety of synovial joint. Okay, so these are the basic questions which are expected. Okay, now let's see the next skyagram. Yes, let's try to identify this skyagram. This is a plane skyagram, dorsoplantar view and oblique view of ankle region and the foot. Okay, we can see the region of ankle joint as well as the foot. Okay, why I'm saying dorsoplantar view? Because the x-rays are passing here from the dorsum aspect of the foot to the plantar aspect of the foot. That's why this is referred to as dorsoplantar view, and this one is the oblique view. Okay, so now here also let's try to identify the bones which are visible. So the lower end of tibia articulates with a bone called as talus. Talus articulates with a bone anteriorly called as the navicular. Then in front of navicular there are three cuneiforms, medial, intermediate and lateral. Then this bone is cuboid, behind which there is calcaneus. The calcaneus bone is seen clearly here. Okay, so in front of calcaneus is cuboid, and in front of talus is navicular, and in front of navicular there are three cuneiform bones. So all this tarsal bones you need to identify here, and these are the metatarsal bones. Metatarsal bones are numbered from the great toe side. This is the first metatarsal, second, third, fourth and fifth. Okay, the fifth metatarsal has got one projection that's referred to as the styloid process of the fifth metatarsal. Okay, and the first metatarsal head shows two small bones here. This is a sesamoid bone in flexor hallucis brevis muscle. Okay, that has this sesamoid bones. Then we can see the phalanges, the great toe having two phalanges, proximal and distal, and the remaining toes are having three phalanges, proximal, middle and the distal phalanx. Okay, so here also you need to name the x-ray correctly, identify all the bones, and then additional viva questions may be asked, like calcaneocuboid joint is which variety of synovial joint? It is a saddle variety of synovial joint. Then other intertarsal joints are plane variety. Okay, then this interphalangeal joints, these are of which type? It is a hinge variety of synovial joint. Okay, so in bones and x-rays, make sure you practice these questions of types of joints. Okay, it is frequently asked. Okay, so these were the three basic x-rays which are kept in lower limb. Okay, thank you.